Did you already find the free violin fingering charts on my website? Maybe you did, maybe you didn't. If you didn't, you can download it below this video. I received a few questions about these fingering charts and, you know, how to use them. So in this video, I would like to give you a quick demonstration of the fingering charts and how you can make use of them and how they work. So first of all, let's look at the first chart in the book. Here you can see a chart of the first position. And you can see that above you will see the violin. The violin is showing where all the notes are on the violin. And you can see that the open strings are displayed over here on the chart. So all the way up. And this would be the G, the D, the A, and the E. Most of you are aware of that. And then above that, you will see which finger to use for every note. So on the violin, there's normally a certain finger that we are using for every note. So for instance, for the G sharp or the A flat, which is the first note that you will see on the chart all the way on the left above, we are normally using the first finger. So here are the fingers. This is finger 1, 2, 3, and 4. So finger 1, finger 2, finger 3, and finger 4. And you can also see that on the chart itself, what the fingers are called. So normally we are always using the same fingers for the same note. So I also included the finger that you would usually use for every note on the chart. So the G sharp or the A flat would normally be played with a first finger. You might be wondering, well, why is there two names? This note actually does have two names. And if you would like to learn more about that, have a look at my video about key signatures. So then you can see that the A is also normally played with the first finger. And then you see that the next note, which is the A sharp or the B flat, is normally played with the second finger and so on. So that is what the upper part of the chart is showing. Now let's have a look at the lower part of the chart. So the lower part of the chart shows you what every note looks like in sheet music and where to play it on the violin. So for instance, let's have a look at the first note on the chart. That would be the E. And here we see an E under the note, and above the note you are seeing a zero. The zero stands for the finger that you are using. So in this case, a zero means no fingers at all. So we have to play on the E string with no fingers at all. So that would be open E string. So that would be the very first note. Then we see the next note, which is the F. The F is played with the first finger on the E string. And now we can have a look at the chart above. The F is the very first finger. So that means that the very first note above the E would be the F, and so on. So you also see that some of the notes are colored in my fingerboard chart. You see some notes are colored blue. This is the place where I place my stickers on the violin. So as you can see, the first note has no sticker, but the second note does have a sticker. So this would be A, E, B, and F sharp. Just like as showed on the fingerboard chart. And the second finger, this would be B, F sharp, and all the notes that you can see there. So this is an easy way to know where the fingers are. Most teachers are putting these fingerboard stickers, if they use them, at the same places. And if you would like to learn how to put these fingerboard stickers on your violin, I have both a blog post on my website violinspiration.com as a YouTube video about that. I will link it below so that you can place those stickers on your violin. So I also included many other charts in this booklet for all the other positions. I would say these charts are more suitable for intermediate and advanced learners, and they are safe to ignore if you are a violin beginner. Because normally, in the beginning, you just learn how to play in first position. For instance, every folk song almost written in this world is in first position. So if you would like to learn how to play folk music, you wouldn't even need these charts. But if you would like to learn classical music, you would need these charts, and at some point you are going to learn to play in higher positions. By the way, if you are somebody that is moving from the beginner stage to the intermediate stage, I would recommend to get started with the third position, not with the second position. So the second chart is not necessarily the second chart that you should learn. And you can find a step-by-step guide how to learn the third position both on my website, violinspiration.com. And you can also find a course on Julia's Violin Academy where I will really take you step-by-step to learn the third position. But anyway, the other charts all have the same principle, with the only difference is that the blue notes are not the stickers on the violin anymore. Because probably at this point you are not using any stickers anymore. So let's have a look at all the other charts. You can see again where to place your fingers, what notes you play with every finger, and also what they look like in sheet music. And this might actually be very useful, especially if you look at the very last chart. The very last chart will show you in which position to play a certain note. And I know that some of you are struggling with that, especially in advanced pieces. You are sending me emails like, hey, Julia, I saw that one note in the piece and there's like a two above it, but in which position should I play it? And this chart will be really useful for that. So you can print that chart if you are a more advanced intermediate player and would like to know in which position to play certain notes, depending on which finger number is used for that note. I hope that these violin fingerboard charts were already very helpful for you and that this explanation gave you a little bit more context how to interpret the charts and how to make use of them. If you haven't downloaded your charts yet, you can do so below this blog post. They are free and I hope that they will really help you in your violin learning and that they will be useful so that you know exactly where to place your fingers. If you're looking for any other free charts, also have a look at the blog post below. I also added some other things like my top 5 skills and so on, and you can all download them for free on my website. If you like the free charts and free violin learning videos that I'm sharing, please consider supporting this channel by subscribing below and clicking the bell notification. Thank you so much for joining today. Bye bye, good luck.